So he's so energy
talking
wrong.
About a rich kid.
Yeah.
What do you expect? He doesn't know what's right from wrong. You know, he plays game all the time. It's not his fault. He was brought up like that. He's an idiot kid. He wasn't very smart to start with. And then his father spoiled him. Because the father feels guilty.
And then the mother kicked the father out of the house. And then married a Chinese husband. And now all the problems solved.
No, he finally has to grow up when he's 35. He's 35 and he's going out there applying for a job and people asking for resume and he's like, how much salary do you expect? Oh, 50 at the back. How much you earned before? I've never earned a single cent.
Hi, Autofiles with Proton Perdana 2.4, aka Accordana.
No, it's not the Accordana, because the Accordana is the one that looks exactly the same. So this is the notchback version of the Perdana. So basically, it's a review of a Honda Accord in the shirt of a Proton. We're here to review what Proton did to this car mostly. Because underneath it, it's a Honda Accord, it's a very competent car. Even by today's standard, it's relatively competent. So let's start with the first one, performance. Yeah. Five-speed auto.
I would take a 5-speed auto over a CVT anyway.
You are right, because CVT is the only CVT I've ever driven that I didn't realize was a CVT was the Audi A4 for the previous generation.
The Multitronic.
Yeah, but then you're paying through your nose for it. 5-speed auto is still better than a CVT. But couldn't you put in a 6? I mean, what age is this, man?
I think Honda didn't have access to a 6-speed auto.
No way.
I think they jumped from 5-speed to 7 to CVT, and then now they've jumped back to automatics, I think 9-speed or 10-speed. But that's very like in that.
It's a high performance range.
High performance range.
Yeah. The expensive range.
Accord in the US. Next Accord.
Yeah, so performance wise, it's okay, 2.4, but I don't feel that it's powerful.
It is competent.
Competent.
I've driven this, the 2.0L and the 2.4 on the new Accord.
Yeah.
And I don't feel it's lacking. Even the 2.0L
is okay.
If you really want to push it, it will go.
It will go.
It's not like lethargic.
So the question then becomes the 2.0L for this, is it okay?
It's okay.
Really okay. I think okay lah. That's a okay.
Yeah. Performance. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Design. When I first saw it, like the glimpses and all that, I said, "Wow!" First thing that jumped into my head was the Holden's.
There was Holden.
Yeah. The what's it? Holden Commodore or something. Like that.
Okay.
They took the older Accord design, which if you see on the road today is kind of a bit old looking. They took that. And
they evolve it
and they did it quite well. Like the panel caps are okay, the build quality is okay. And daytime running lights, instead of it being individual LEDs.
Oh, it's one line.
It's one line.
Oh, it's like the modern Mercedes and the modern BMW.
Yes, it's like a modern like daytime
Audi,
running light.
One stream.
And it's uniform. Okay. And, it's nice touches. And you know, the car has been around for like 2 years now. And this car, the lights are still running. So,
which is a good thing.
Which is a good thing.
It doesn't look that aged. It looks okay. You like the exterior?
I like the exterior. Like I mentioned before, the daytime running lights look very modern.
Okay. You know, the uniform. Details that are very modern.
And even if you zoom into the lights, they're even etched Proton on
in the lights.
In the lights.
It's like, so BMW.
BMW, Mercedes, all there now.
It's like, put in the lights, BMW, LV. What's that supposed to put?
In case you forget.
In case you forget, it's a BMW. I spent some money on this. Just, so childish, isn't it?
Yeah, it's quite tacky.
Okay, so you like the looks?
I like the looks exterior. Except for the rear, there's one part there with the fake exhaust.
You just gotta take a picture.
I will show it up close. I think it is hideous. I think that's something that is a cost or a problem for Proton. Interior, all the Honda touches that are put in are okay.
They didn't change much in the interior.
It's
basically a Honda Accord.
Yes.
Steering wheel is different.
Steering wheel is Proton's one. Yeah, they did the head unit themselves. And this entire piece out here, it matches with the aircon controls which are from Honda.
Some thought.
Which is maybe they just got the paint code from Honda and they just copy paste.
They got the artistic side okay lah.
Yeah.
The concept, the artistic side, but overall, there was a bit of poor execution lah.
Yes.
I think that's been the story of Proton all the while.
Yeah. Sad to say it hasn't changed. Let's elaborate.
No, it hasn't changed in the sense that it hasn't changed up to now at this point in time. This is the worst period.
This is like
the divorce going on before the mother married the
tantrum. So yeah, let's get into a bit of detail. So it's not just like we're not just talking infotainment system. Sound quality is just I can't understand it. Sometimes some speakers are blasting different parts of the song. It might work if it's a CD or USB or what, but when it's FM. and you're getting different wavelengths coming from different speakers.
It sounds messy.
It sounds very messy. Also, I don't like that this radio thing is completely unintuitive. It is functional. You've got auxiliary, you've got FM, you've got USB, SD card, but no lah.
No lah.
Doesn't look so
good. A typical situation of design, okay, execution gone wrong. On the inside, Proton injected their, get their fiddly hands into two parts, from what we can see. One is the infotainment system, which Subhash just now elaborated. The other part that Proton did something to the car is the steering wheel itself. One look at it, you know the execution went wrong.
Yeah.
The design-wise, I wouldn't give it a 7 or 8 out of 10. It's normal, lah. Okay, lah, 5 out of 10 or whatever. It's not important, actually. You can have a very simple, steering wheel. It's enough. The problem is the badge itself. I mean, you're paying upwards of 100,000 ringgit for a car. At least, lah, give me a proper badge. This is a plastic molded badge I find on the Proton Vira from 1998.
And
no, more.
2003.
Towards the end, when that car is about to, when it's not supposed to be produced anymore, you find that that's not the worst part. So I was just touching it, fiddling it, playing with it. Then something cut my hand. Yeah, and if I were to move faster, it literally would have cut my hand or finger. It was a plastic piece at the back near the pedal shifter. Okay, that was not
glued on or stuck on properly.
It was not clipped on properly, or maybe it could not be clipped on properly at all. My goodness, I tell you, that thing is a danger. It is razor sharp and it doesn't fit whatever it is I'm trying to clip it on and see whether it clips. It doesn't
clip.
So
no,
it will
there.
Forever be like that. This is not acceptable, Proton.
You had two jobs in this car, that and that. This one, okay, acceptable, I guess. But that is quite scary.
You had one job, don't hurt your customer. Fingers.
And also, since you were talking about the badge just now, the badge that's on the steering wheel is the old Proton logo with the Proton,
the word itself there.
Yeah. Fine, if you want to put it there, then okay, we understand it's an old mold, blah, blah, blah. But in front and in the back, outside, it's the new badge.
Mm.
And then on the rims, it's the old badge again.
Uh-huh.
So it's like old badge, new badge, old badge, new badge. Like, what the hell is going on?
And here's the worst part, this car is made to represent the country, It's so sad, lah. It goes back to the same thing you say about the exhaust. It's fake. Okay, fine. Industry, I don't like the way it goes, fake exhaust. But even that also, you can't even bother to color it different. It's how do you respect yourself? I also don't know. It's like the SEA Games. They get other people's country flag wrong.
Yeah.
It's that kind of, it's the same level of thing.
So, conclusion time. Would you buy a used Accord? The last year they made the Honda Accord of this generation.
Versus this brand new?
Was 2012, 2013.
Okay.
You can still 2013. Get a loan.
Okay, you can still get a loan.
The prices are between 50,000 to 80,000.
Let's say 70 lah. Let's say 70,000 for a 2012
Accord. 2.4, same 2.4. Everything.
Okay. Or a Proton Perdana.
Perdana.
How much is it?
This is about 120.
120, yeah. 70 versus 120. Yeah. I don't know how to justify.
The warranty is the only thing.
But I heard that Honda parts are expensive.
Yeah, that's
true. My friend did sell off his car because the maintenance has start piling up, but it gets quite expensive. Yes. I'm surprised,
I'm still on the fence, because of how expensive some Honda parts can be.
Yeah.
Especially Accord level.
Yeah.
Usually Civic is still okay.
Honda Accord can get pretty scary. I may actually buy the new one. Because if I'm gonna buy this car, chances are I don't care too much about image. It's all about getting a value for money and also getting a comfortable vehicle to carry you around. Of course, I don't mind this car so much because construction-wise, it's a Honda, so robustness level is adequate lah. It will work. There's not many D segment car you can get for 110,000. So actually, it does make sense if you're getting a 2-liter version. So that's Autofiles from a Proton lah. This is the Proton, mind you. We are reviewing Proton in its worst form. This is not indicative of Proton after or before. This is Proton in its worst period. I already put it into P.
You can off the sensor.
Dude, that's not how it's supposed to work. When you put it into P, it's not supposed to. There you go, we just found another fault. Autofile signing out from Proton Perdana.
2.4.
Question is this, BMW and Mercedes spare parts are even worse. They show off, my maintenance last month, 8,000 ringgit, or they say louder, 8,000 ringgit. Mercedes car 7 you 8,000 you know that day my 7G Tronic
10,000
I think it's like a passive aggressive show up. Yeah. I can afford to suffer. You cannot suffer. I can never.